Billy Boy! Ah!
Here, I know they're here. Yes. This is perfect.
No!
Bill the Bug Man, what's bugging you?
William! Hey, it's me, Glinda!
Hey, Glinda.
How are you?
Oh, hold on. I got a buffet here.
Hey, do you know where this missing video is?
No, Glinda. You have it. You've always had it.
That's a real stinker.
Try calling Dan. He might know where it is. Oh, I got you. Live meat.
Please hold. All right, last one here. Dan. Oh, I hope he got my website done.
It was a Friday. Another bitter and cold sunset to bookend another lonely week. To top it off, the Times had nothing good to read. It stinks being down on my luck. Hungry, broke, and out of work. And that's when it happened. An unimaginable terror, an event that would change my life. The obituary was empty. No work for me. Oh yeah, and then there was her.
Are you Dan Adams?
Last time I checked.
I have a packet here with information for you to save the world. Keep this safe, and good luck.
Save the world? I can save the world? What was that all about? And who was this dame? Wow, she looked a lot like my mom. Hello?
Mr. Willie Make It?
No, this is Detective Adams.
Hey, who's messing up the intel? I'm sorry, Mr. Adams. You've been chosen to complete this mission.
What do you mean?
Don't ask questions! You have 3 minutes and 17 seconds to go to the payphone at the corner of 5th and Main. Answer it or the world will end. No distractions! I know you have ADD. I've read your profile.
Well, I was on the job again. Time was short and I had a... Oh look, a bunny! Darn, that rabbit was faster than I thought. I would have caught him had it not been for the aroma of that deep dish pizza. Well, luckily, I got to the phone on time. Hello? Or maybe not. Hello?
Where have you been? Told you no distractions.
What?
Never mind. There's a woman who'll be delivering a briefcase to you. In it, you will find a tape with valuable information. Listen carefully. The intel is vital to your success. It's imperative that you are there for the drop-off.
When?
I'm working with morons.
Out of nowhere, the briefcase appeared. It was the only one around, so I assumed it was for me. With my mind racing, thinking of all the clues that could be within, I wasted no time looking for the tape. The first piece of evidence was a bloody leather glove with 5 fingers, none of them pointing me in the right direction. Suddenly, I was thirsty for a glass of OJ. This just didn't fit. The next piece of evidence was the one I needed. I was curious as to what was on it. How could this save the world?
Hello, Mr. Adams. You're dealing with me now. Who I am is not important, but what is important is that you follow these instructions carefully. My bus will be arriving tonight at 5:05 p.m. It is critical for you to be at the bus station to see me. I'll be in a pink dress, but you mustn't try to contact or speak with me. There will be a man arriving in a white car to pick me up. He is your poison, your targeted enemy. You can bet your asset on that. Follow him at all costs. My life isn't significant. Stay focused, Mr. Adams. I believe you will know what to do. Use your instincts and follow your heart.
The time was 5:07 p.m. The bus had been on schedule, which is rare in this town. I hadn't run that hard since the double cheeseburger went on the dollar menu, but I had made it. People were coming and going like mad, but no one in a pink dress. Not yet, at least. The search had to continue. As I listened to the thunderous roar of the diesel motors, a web of questions filled my thoughts. Who is this broad in the pink dress? How does this lonely gumshoe fit into the world-saving scenario? And what kind of license does it take to drive one of these massive vehicles? I was needing answers, and fast. I think time was running out. I slunk into the shadows, and my hopes began to fade like the daylight. As the final bus pulled away, I caught a whiff of a terrible stench. I couldn't tell if it was from the dumpster or just myself. I checked my watch to see what time I had, and that's when I spotted her, a lady in pink. She was a real looker, the kind of dame that makes a man crawl like a leopard in heat. I watched her closely, trying to figure out who she was and how she was involved in this whole mess. I was glad to be back on the beat, but why warn me? And why a pink dress? Didn't she know that you shouldn't wear pink after Labor Day? I wondered if we'd both make it out alive. I was deep in thought when the headlights of the white car cut through the darkening night. My target pulled into the station, but it was too dark to make him, so I started to make mental notes. Who was this perp, and who was he involved with? Could he be a terrorist, or just another layer on the iceberg of low-life crime? Where does he come from? What are his likes and dislikes? Does he take long walks on the beach in the moonlight? And did I forget to turn off my oven? That's neither here nor there. What I really needed to know was how he was going to end the world. That, and how was I going to follow him?